It has been a very productive week. I got quite a few tumblers done. I apologize for the hissing sound. I do try to get it turned down as much as possible. I do have my compressor turned off, so it shouldn't pop on you guys. Shout out to my wife in the background. So I do want to share with you guys, we're going to be trying to go live more often and upload at least once a week. I need to start sharing how I'm doing this a little more in depth. So sorry for the camera glare. Let me see if I can help with that. Ah, much better. A reference photo. Today we've got two of these guys that we're going to be adding some color to, and then I think I'm going to shoot one more video tonight before I go to bed. I think I'm going to do a galaxy, so keep an eye out for that. I'm going to grab a darker color. So, I know I get a lot of questions about what kind of airbrushes I'm using, so I still have my good old trusty handy dandy Master Airbrush. I love this one for just the size of the cup, but that last airbrush was my Iwata HP CH. It's my workhorse. That's what I do most of my painting with. A little thicker, so I think I want to just go and be a little sluggish today, I see. Probably take a little more reducer to it, but I actually like this. So I got my reference photo over here on my tablet, and I'm just kind of looking back and forth to see kind of where some of these tones and shades are in relation to others. A lot of this is going to get black over the top to kind of make it blend in. I'm trying to keep it fairly soft. I did go through with my transparent black this morning, trying to darken in all of these polka dots. I don't want to bore you guys with that part. It was very tedious. It was very, very, very tedious. I'm not too concerned with overspray on this one, because I think I'm going to be going over this with something else at the end of the process, but I'm undecided yet. Looking for a freehand shield, don't mind me. Just a little bit of color on this back. I'm gonna keep these branches a little separate. Sorry about that. I'm a lefty, so this is a little challenging. I apologize. I think that'll work. That's close enough. So I make these on my Cricut machine. Yeah, this one's a bit dirty, but these freehand shields are great to get nice crisp edges all the way out to like soft edges also. Constantly jumping back to my reference photo. It's weird. Let me see if I can show you this. So I've got two reference photos I'm working on. So that's the first reference photo I'm working on, and then I was trying to work on this one, but it doesn't have any color, so we're gonna add color to it. It's weird having headphones with no music. Using Createx Paints. I'm also using 4011 Reducer. These I just mixed up beforehand, so most of these are 1-to-1 in terms of a ratio. This is the one I was talking about with my cast and color too. Sorry if I'm in front of the camera. Didn't take too long. I still have quite a bit more to go on this one. But again, I did a lot of prep work this morning, knowing that I was going to be recording this evening to just get this kind of block. little bit of transparent base into my original mixture, and that seemed to work a little better. It flowed a little better. Jumping back and forth in between colors.
Just trying to bring this to life. The color is a little bit
dark for me, but
okay.
That's where we get to do
some things on our own to make it look the way we want to.
Another thing I wanted to talk about on this video was about how you can make passive income by using your airbrush. So there are a couple of easy ways, and one of which is going out and doing craft fairs. Local craft fairs, your high school craft fairs, those are all quick, easy ways to get yourself out there, make some extra spare change, show other people what you can do. Sorry, I've mixed up a little reduced down sepia just to kind of blend this dark spot down here. I don't want to go straight black yet. Anyway, one of the other ways is to do tumblers, like what I'm doing here. And another way is to go out, I'm trying to blend these two colors together, I apologize. But tumblers, craft fairs, doing temporary tattoos, company parties. Those are always good ways to make extra money, make passive income. So, you know, active income is when you're sitting at your 9-to-5 making X dollars per hour. Passive income is the other streams of revenue that you are able to build
while you are not at your 9-to-5 job. So for us, martial artistry is one of our passive streams of income. There are lots of ways to get set up, but airbrushing is a pretty low cost way of doing so.
So something we're going to be doing here soon is kind of jumping back to art, but continuing our flow of tumblers, because people seem to like them, and they have a pretty good return on investment for us. We're in a very unique place, so we see a lot of tourists every day. Like a lot of tourists every day. I am pretty sure all week this week we saw 40,000 to 50,000 visitors this week. So it's been like that since all of our restrictions got lifted here where we live. So business has been growing pretty steadily. And so it's caused us to have to adjust. And this is one of the ways that we've been able to do so. been incorporating tumblers into our business model. There are a couple of different ways to do this. I'm going to be showing all of them that I have discovered here in some near future videos. We have to get our affiliate links set up this week so that we get you guys the information for some of the products that we use. Our colors are coming out nicely. Anyway, don't forget to hit like and share and subscribe. Definitely we'll have some new content coming up soon. Alright, I have to mix up the color right there. So I'm using 40 of those in the diffuser, Createx Paints. I'm a water-based paint system guy. It allows me to do what I need to do, but also I'm still learning, growing, expanding, evolving as an artist. So I try to use every tool at my disposal. I don't really stick to any one thing per se. Whatever it takes to keep the client happy, that's what you should be using. They're the one paying the bill, so. What you see. Don't forget to give it a like and a thumbs up. Feel free to share with a friend, a family member, etc. Again, let me know if you guys have questions. We are still getting our camera set up together, so please don't mind all the hissing in the background. We are going to get that together for you guys. We want you guys to have nothing but the best. But it's time. So, this is looking pretty good so far. We are gonna pause for a second and mix up another color, one that's a little in between, and probably a white and a black, and we will be right back. Alright, we're back. I had to let my compressor fill up. I didn't want you guys to have to hear that. Got some reduced black in here. I'm just trying to blend this in a little more.
and peel off of this, and we will be back with another tutorial here shortly. Thank you guys for joining. I am going to peel off of this and mix up some other colors, try and get this wrapped up. I just wanted to share with you for a little bit my process, doing some shading, trying to bring this bad boy to life. Don't forget to hit like, share, and subscribe. We appreciate you. Mahalo.